In February this year, inside Moscow's Christ Saviour Cathedral, something unusual happened. Five women stood up and prayed for an end to Vladimir Putin's rule. They called it a punk prayer. The women are members of Pussy Riot, an anonymous feminist protest band. This is their video of the performance, set to a recording of the prayer. Mother Mary, please drive Putin away, they scream. Days later, three women were arrested. Two of them, mothers to young children. They've been in custody ever since. They're charged with hooliganism and could face a seven-year sentence. This caged woman is Nadia Talakanikova. This is her husband, Peter Versilov, and Gera, the four-year-old daughter she hasn't seen in 4 months.
When you've had those fleeting glimpses of her in the courtroom, how does she look? How do you think she's taking it?
She looks very good, and she's taking it as she's supposed to take it, as very political and very artistic and very solid and creative and powerful person.
Pussy Riot specializes in sudden, often illegal public performances, like this one in Red Square.
We did realize that at some point we could get arrested. That was always the possibility. But of course, no one expected that the arrest would come after this particular performance.
The punk prayer was inspired by the women's anger over the relationship between the Russian government and the Orthodox Church. The Orthodox leader, Patriarch Kirill, has been widely reported as saying, Putin's years in power have been a miracle from God. But the band's behaviour in one of Russia's most sacred cathedrals has outraged many of the country's faithful. This is a disgusting thing to do, says this woman. They should go to jail, says another. A year or two, let them think about their behaviour. But some of those offended also believe the women should not be in jail. If necessary, God will punish them, says this man. It must not be a cruel punishment. The women also have passionate supporters who say they are victims of political persecution. Peter is in no doubt and has told his daughter who's to blame.
Gira knows that Putin has put Nadia in prison and he's not letting her out. And we have to find a way to defeat him to free Nadia.
The Russian president hasn't commented on the case. Pussy Riot is only one small part of the recent anti-Putin protest movement, but the decision to jail and prosecute these women has ensured the band's colourful face masks have become one of the opposition's most powerful symbols. Phil Black, CNN, Moscow.